Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video I'm going to discuss about how to create a static and dynamic website and what is the difference between pages, posts and categories, and by using these all options how we can create a website effectively, and we can see how to optimize our footer and widgets as well. So let's get started. Now let me ask you a few things. What is the difference between static website and then dynamic website? Static and dynamic website.
Static, the front page will not change, and the dynamic we can have insert the sliders and other options.
Okay, so now you have to tell me shiva.thenaturehealth.in. So what type of website it is?
It's static.
It's a static. And Prabhu's website? So what is the Prabhu's website? It's a static or dynamic?
Static.
Yes. Okay, static. Someone says static. And the next, this coroad.thenaturehealth.in? Come on.
Guess all of it. These are static because it's not premium, but we can enter whatever we want.
Okay, we so
themes.
Right. So you it means that when I go with the premium things only, I can make it dynamic. Otherwise, all the free themes are static only, right?
Yeah, that's what my understanding.
So now ODMT is there. ODMT, we have designed this ODMT with the free themes, only with the free theme. So no premium theme with the ODMT. So now what type of website it is? It is static or dynamic. So first of all, let me clear the thing.
All websites are dynamic.
See, first let me explain you difference between static and dynamic.
Okay.
So static website. Site means your website won't change with the new updates. Okay, so now if I open this ndtv.com, whenever you open the ndtv.com, you can see some fresh news over there. Are you going to see any old news? So here after hard position or new map and something here. So when I open this ndtv.com tomorrow, can you see the same news?
No,
right? So now this ndtv.com is a dynamic website. That means if your front page is going to change according to the new post, according to the new updates you have in your website, then it isn't a dynamic. So if it is not changing, it is a static. Okay. So now you understand the difference between static and dynamic. If I open in ODMT, what type of website it is? Type of website?
It's dynamic.
Only homepage is static.
Yeah, so my website odmt.in is static or dynamic. Is it continuously changing?
So it is a static.
It is a static. So I'm not going to show any recent posts or else any recent activities in my front page. Whereas NDTV, it is showing all the recent activities on the front page. This is what just difference between static means it never changes. So every time, whenever you open the website, it will show the same content. So for service-oriented kinds of website, now here Prabhu's website is there. So he was trying to provide some services. So he can go with the static website. Now Kirtika has a fashion website. So she would like to have some fashion blogs. At that time, she can go with the dynamic website. And Akanksha has started some digital marketing kinds of website. She can go with the static website. So depends on your requirement. You can make any website into static or dynamic. I told you, right? I am going to show you how to create a static and dynamic website. Right. So yes, not only with the premium themes, I can make my website into dynamic with the free themes as well. Okay. Now let us see how we can make it. Now, again, one more thing. If I click this home page, now what are these? These are home, student zone. What are these?
Menu.
Normally? Yeah, menu, right? What are these?
Header menu.
Subfolders. Am I right? Subfolders or not?
Yeah.
Yes. So when I click this home page, what is my URL? Is it changing?
No.
No. When I click this blogs, so is it changing?
Yes, ma'am.
So then why it is not changing with the home and why it is changing with the blogs? So this is with the dizzycourse.in. Now let me open the some other's website. What is this website? Shiva's. Shiva has a few subfolders like home, about us, modules and all. Let me click this home. So why the home page is appearing as like this and why like this in my website? Why? What happened?
The subdomain.
Subdomain? Okay, Prabhu, right? So yeah. Prabhu, tell me the difference between subfolder and subdomains.
Subfolders and subdomains. I got confused. The subdomains are the domain additional domains of the main domain, and the subfolders are the sub pages of the domain.
Simply. So now tell me, how can you say that this is as a subdomain?
Because
this is a subfolder only, right?
Yeah.
And what about my website? So when I click this home, my web page URL is not changing. So again, it is showing me as a dizzycourse.in. Okay, so observe carefully. So now when someone searches for dizzycourse.in, I am trying to show my home page directly. Indirectly, am I right? Can you see here? This home is highlighted. Now when I go with the ODMT also, when I click this home page, so observe the URL. Is it changing? Is it changing?
No.
No, right? So that means when someone searches for odmt.in, I want to show my home page. That means, so here I made this home page as a static page, and when someone searches for a particular website, I can show only that particular page. That is what simply static website. So usually and normally all WordPress websites will be a dynamic websites. So now Shiva's and then Kirtika's and Ramya's, everyone websites are dynamic websites only. So again, recognize that website as a dynamic with one more thing. You can see some recent posts over there, and that recent post will show with a date of application. You know, when the post is published in your website, so that date also it will show. If I can open this and shiva.thenaturehealth.in. You see these, when I scroll down here, I can see Hello World. What is this Hello World? Normally it is showing me some May 26, 2020. Mm-hmm. What does it mean? So it is showing me the post. Okay. So now when someone searches for shiva.denature.health.in, so it is showing me some recent posts. Okay. Yesterday I told you to create some post categories. How many of you done with this post and role? I told you to find out the difference between post, pages, and categories. How many of you?
I tried, but I was not able to create any categories.
Okay. You created posts, sir.
I tried to create a post blog.
And Akanksha, have you tried?
I make a one post on a blog.
Okay. Okay, what is the difference here? So pages means you already know. Pages is for constant content. Pages is for showing your static content. So if you don't want to change anything, if you don't want to show any recent updates in your website, at the time you can just happily choose this pages. So, and then post is used for having blogs in your website. So to write a blogs. Now NDTV is there. So NDTV, how NDTV is pushing these things? So they have an option post. By using this options for post only, they can show the new updates in the website. Here also, the post is, you can use this post option to write some blogs. So I want to write a topic called what is digital marketing topic. So at that time you can choose this post option. Then categories. So what is this categories means? If you want to categorize the blogs in some folder, so at that time you can choose this categories. Okay, now let me show you one more example. You have to understand here. I click on SEO and AdWords here. So what is my URL? Can you tell me? So how is it appearing?
Category/SEO.
Okay, now that means SEO is a category here, and category/AdWords. That means AdWords is a category here. Okay, when I click this SEO, I can see some recent posts we have in my website. Now, like, you know, November 26, we wrote a blog on November 21. So if it is showing with the particular date, means what does it mean? It is a post. Right? Post. Okay. Date. Okay. Do remember. Now, what type of website it is? If I'm showing the all recent posts in one folder, that means it is a dynamic website, right? But what happened here? I made this website as a both static and dynamic. How I can make that? So dynamic. Only because of categories. Okay. So now I created a page called home. The category is called SEO and AdWords, and I made that post under this SEO and AdWords category. So when you have a categories only, you can categorize your blogs. Otherwise, no way to. Now let us say you want to write a thousands of blogs in your website. Where you want to show? So you don't want to show in the homepage. Then where would you like to show all the recent posts you write in your blog? Are you going to show in the direct menu session? So is it possible to show all your thousands of blogs in the menu session on top side? No, right? It is not at all possible for us. That is the reason I created some categories to store all of my recent posts, so that when someone click on this SEO and AdWords and Google Analytics, they can see all the recent blogs we have in our website. Okay. So now let me show you how we can create this post categories. Then I'll show you how to make this static and dynamic. Let us get into this website.
A quick question.
So what is? Yes.
So when we are able to write or show something, a recent content, we are already using blogs. Then what is the use of AdSense, Analytics and SEO?
Sorry? What is the use of? I understood your topic. So what is the use of adding this AdWords Analytics folders you are asking, right?
We are already putting blogs, and in blog we are already giving recent activity, whatever we are doing in blogs. Then again, why
in blogs? So so now I have a different kinds of blogs. So digital marketing means I have a different topics. Now SEO is one topic and Google Analytics is one topic and Google AdWords is one topic. Let us say if you want to segregate all your all your kinds of SEO topics under SEO folder, at that time you can create a SEO category. So it depends on your requirement again. So if you want to segregate all kinds of particular blogs under some particular category, now when someone click on this SEO, they can see only SEO blogs. When someone click on this AdWords, they can see only AdWords blog. When someone click on this Google Analytics, they can see only Google Analytics blogs. If you want to segregate, or else if you click on this blog, you can see all the recent activities in my blog page. Okay, irrespective of the particular categories, you can see all my recent posts in the blog page. Getting my point?
Yeah.
Yes, cleared. So depends on your requirement. If you want to segregate all the topics, you can do, or else you can directly show in the blog page. So here I just want to give a idea for my students that yes, this is what the topics under SEO, these are the topics under AdWords. I just want to show that is the reason I made these kinds of things. Okay. Got it now?
Yeah.
Okay. So now let me open my website and start creating some blogs and then categories. Okay. So again, what I'm trying to say here, can you make all blogs to show under some page? Can you do that? All blogs under some pages.
All blogs under one page.
Pages. Yes, page.
Using modules.
Okay, so let me create a post now. Let me see. Let us say that I want to write a hello world. This is a by default post you have in your WordPress website. So I want to delete it now. Let me write post. That means post is used for writing blogs. Okay, let's say that this visitor and I just write something here. Here I wrote some blog on what is digital marketing, right? So I just want to create a few more blogs like this. And this is SEO. And one more blog I'll write. So can I do this thing with the help of pages? Why only I have to choose a post to write a blogs? Why not pages?
Because all these posts will represent in pages.
Okay.
You can segregate, you know, as you said just now, all the SEO information in one page.
One page. Clarity. Page. There is a lot of difference between page categories and then post.
You can segregate this information in one post by using category option.
Post. So here I'm writing a post, then again, how I can segregate under post. Okay, don't worry, I'll clear. So now how many blogs I have?
Three.
One, two, three. Let me open my website in another tab. Can you see what is Google Ads, what is SEO, and what is digital marketing? What all these?
Posts,
right. So how you are going to recognize as it is a post?
Because of the date.
because I can see some admin and date. So here, when is a published date also. So if for only post, you can see this published today, not for the pages. You cannot see these things for the pages. Okay. So now what type of website it is?
Dynamic
website. Okay. Now let us see. Let me go and create a categories now. So how you can create a categories is, here you have an option called categories. Can you see? Under post option. Yeah. Just go there. Water. Right. So now let us say that I'm going to create some categories like SEO. Add new category. And the next comes is Google Ads. Digital marketing. Okay. Three categories I have. Let me open my website and then refresh it. Oh, can you tell me where are my categories?
Under module.
Okay. Is this our categories? Okay, let me click this SEO. So how is my URL? So then tell me, is it a page or category?
The support.
Page.
It is a page. Okay, it is a page. It is not a category. If it is a category, it will show me like a category/SEO. Okay, so now tell me where are my categories, where they are showing up in your website, where?
You have to add it to menu.
Very good. Who said this? Kirtika. See now, yesterday we have added few pages. Unless until I add them into a menu section, no one can see those pages. Am I right? So now I just created categories. That's it. You haven't assigned the position for your categories. Now let us say I want to show up those things in the menu session. So tell me the process, how I can show them?
Under appearance, ma'am.
Okay, under appearance.
No.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
Menus.
Menus or customize?
Customize.
So menus. We have to get into the menus. Right. So now
we have to.
Yesterday we have. So what is this menu? NH menu. Yesterday we have created two menus, right? So this menu is, I have selected for footer menu. So as of now, I just need to choose this 9 p.m. batch, okay? And then select it. So what are the things I have? Home, about us, modules, right? So here, if you can see left side, the categories option, okay? Yesterday I told you, we can add subfolders into a menu section. Am I right? So yesterday we just finished with the pages. So now you can add a categories as well. Right. So if you click this, we all, how many categories I created?
Three.
Okay. So now whatever the categories you want to show in the menu section, you can just click them. Add to menu. Okay. So it will show you. So now digital marketing is a category. Google Ads is a category and SEO is a category. So if you want to change the positions, you can simply drag and drop. Okay. And then save menu. And then go back to our website. Refresh it. Can you see now? Home, about us, modules, contact us, SEO, Google Ads, and digital marketing. So again, see here, when I click this SEO, what is the URL? So what is the difference between this URL and this URL?
That is a page and this is a category.
This is a category. Okay. Now I created a three categories. Tell me now what I can do with these categories. What I can do?
In these categories, we can post.
we can segregate the post into that categories, right? So now let us see how we can segregate some post into the categories. So go to the posts now. So what is digital marketing is it? So edit. And so now this is a blog, right? I want to segregate this blog under some category. So here right side, if you can see, you can see an option called categories. Okay. So just choose this. It will show you the categories. As of now, it is an uncategorized. So I'm just unchecking it. And I want to show is this blog into digital marketing category and update it. Then go back. So tell me in which category I just want to choose now to see that post. Digital marketing. Let me click this. Can you see now what is digital marketing have been segregated into a digital marketing category? So now when I click this Google AdWords, can I see the Google Ads category post? Nothing
found.
Yes, we haven't categorized it. So in such a way, you can categorize each and every blog. Can I categorize the pages then? Okay, I'll show you how to do that even. Now SEO is there. Let me edit it. And then go to categories. I want to show this blog under the SEO category. Update. So this Google Ads, I want to show under Google Ads category. So you can choose a quick edit option to quickly edit something. So I just choose now. Okay, now I want to show this. What is SEO under Google Ads category? Can I show that? Can I show? I want to show this. What is it? Yes, we can, right? So it's up to you. It's up to you simply. So I just want to show in SEO as well as Google Ads category. Let us go back and then let us see. Let me click this SEO. Can you see now what is SEO in the SEO category? Then Google Ads. Can you see? I have segregated this post and this post under Google Ads category, right? So now fine. And then in the digital marketing category also, it is showing. Then what about my front page? So will all my blogs appear in the front page or not?
No. It is.
It is. Why? I already segregated them. Then why all those things are appearing in my front page? Why?
This latest post.
Very good. See, as of now, my website is a still dynamic website. Okay. So if you segregate or if you don't also, if it is a dynamic website, all your recent post is going to appear in a front page. Okay. It doesn't matter that whether you segregated or not. No. So if it is a dynamic, all your recent posts will appear. Okay. Now let me show you. Can I segregate some post under any pages? Now you might have got some doubt why I have to choose only post. I can just go and create some pages and I can segregate under categories now. So why only post? Let me show you that even. Instead of writing some blogs in a post option, I can just go and write in a pages now. So just go to pages. And here we have a few pages like home and about us. Let me write one more thing here. Okay. What is digital marketing? Okay. Now tell me, can I segregate this under category called digital marketing category?
No, ma'am.
Why? So because here we don't have an option of segregating this page under some category. That is the reason if you want to segregate anything, you just need to choose a post, not a page. Okay, then what is the use of having a pages now? Tell me, what is the use of pages? It is for constant content. Let us say you have created one about us page. So if you want to show something on in about us page, you can just show, you can just write in the about us section. Okay, it is for constant content. Now like a home page or about us, like contact us, you can just go and have a unique constant over there, unique content over there. Got it now? So now did you understand the difference between pages, post and categories? Right. Now let me show you how we can make a, any website into a static or dynamic. Right. So it's simple option, one option, that's it. So with the just simple one option, you can create a static or dynamic. So just go to appearance and go to customize option. So scroll down. So this option will be same for each and every website. Okay, each and everything, whatever the theme you install, this option will be present. So now homepage settings, can you see? Go there and your homepage displays. What does it mean? Your homepage displays your latest posts. So all your WordPress website displays all your recent post tool. Now I have whatever the recent post I have in my website, so it will show in my front page. So no, I don't want to show all the recent posts. It has to be static. That I'm a static page. Okay. So now again, what page you want to show as a front page? Okay. Here you can see, if you click on this drop down, it will show what all the pages you have. About us, contact us, Google Ads, homepage, modules, as you want. So I just choose this homepage and publish it. Go back now and see, this is the thing it is showing. Let me show you. Refresh it. So can you see now any recent posts here? Mm-hmm. Any recent posts?
No, ma'am.
No. So again, let me click this home URL. Is it changing my website URL? It has to come like this, right? Dot in slash home. Why it is not appearing? Mm-hmm. Prabhu, tell me why this slash home is not appearing. So why the URL is same?
Yeah, because we have selected the home page option as
the front page, right? Yeah. So now can I make any page as a front page? Can I show any page as a front page?
Yes we can.
So now let us say I want to show some about us page and publish it. Let's go back and refresh it again. So can you see now which page it is showing me as a front page? Mm-hmm. Which page?
About us.
About us. How you are recognizing? So it is highlighting. Now let me click on this home option. So is my URL is changing or not?
It is.
Why? Why it is changing?
Because now we have selected the home page as about us.
About us. So if you click this about us, see that URL. Am I right? So now whatever you want to show in the front page, you can directly write in that about us section. So now let's say you want to show the front page as the about us page, right? So whatever you write in the about us section, so that will appear. Okay. Now, okay, fine. I told you, right? We can segregate only post under only categories, right? Can I categorize any post under some pages? Can I do that? Can I segregate any post under some pages? Here I have a few pages like SEO, Google Ads and SMM. can I show that what is SEO blog under SEO page? Can I show?
Yes, we can.
Yes.
Sure.
Yes.
Okay, let us go back to a dashboard and see. Okay, I want to segregate this. What is digital marketing under SEO page? Tell me now. So edit it. Yes. Tell me now. So here I have a categories option. Here I have a
SEO.
Click on
SEO.
This SEO.
Yeah.
This SEO, your then it is a category, no?
Category.
I want to segregate this post under SEO page. I want to show, not under this category.
Okay. Can we copy the URL of that page and copy and paste it on permalink?
So then how it would be like a segregate? So I want to now. What is digital marketing is not only I want to show, I want to show what is SEO under when under SEO. So if you paste that link, you will redirect. No, I'm not asking about redirection. I want to show under SEO page, all my blogs. Can I do that?
You do that
simple
in customize,
question.
Ma'am.
Customize? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, see here, do remember, so we can't never ever can make any post under pages. Okay, so we can segregate some post under categories only. So page is used for only writing something, writing constant content, that's it. So no other use with the pages, whereas post is used for writing blogs and categories used for categories. Okay, so that is what right name for categories, for categorizing the blogs. Okay, and for pages, I cannot categorize, I cannot segregate my post under pages. Did you understand now? Cleared? Okay, one more question for you. Can I segregate the pages under categories? Can I show my pages under categories? No, right, we cannot because I don't have an option. Right, this is what we can do it. So use these pages for writing constant content, blogs for post, and then categories. And let me open this ODMT now. You have to observe the difference here. Let me click this blog option. So what is my URL here? ODMT.in/blog. Then what is this here? What type of subfolder it is? It is a
page.
Yes, it is a page. So now what I can see under page, what are these?
Post.
Okay, then I asked you one question. Can I segregate the post under pages?
It's a constant content.
It is not constant. Can you see? These are blogs. Now if I go and write something like what is Google Ads, it will appear here. So how it can be a constant content? So these things are changing, right, continuously. So now it is a May 9th, May 8th, and May 7th. So today it's a May 7th, 27th. If I write a blog today, so it will appear here. So that means that page is continuously changing with the recent post you have in your website. How is it happening? And it is a page, and I already told you we cannot segregate all the posts into some page. And we do not have any option of segregating under some pages. Then
it
how?
Just updates in the page, so it automatically gets updated here.
Sorry, it is?
Later updates can be categorized in pages. So whatever we are updating latest will be coming into that page.
Can I categorize latest updates under pages?
Latest updates.
Do we have option? So latest updates means I choose a post to write updates. So in NDTV, we call them as a news. In ODMT, we call them as a blogs. in some kinds of updates website, we call them as the updates. But whatever the website might be, we were choosing the post option only. Now, tell me now. Yes, simple question. See here. Go back to your website. And you can see an option called customize over there. Customize. Go to home page settings.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you see here? Yes. We have a home page and post to page.
Yeah.
Okay. So here post to page means whatever the post, whatever the recent post you have in your website, if you just choose any one of the page you have here, in that page your complete recent post will appear. If you don't, it won't appear. If you select, it appears. So now if I choose this drop down, it will show what all the pages I have. Let us say that about us, sorry, contact us. Let me choose this contact us and then publish it. Go back, refresh it. So where my blogs appears? Blogs. Where my recent posts appears?
Contact us.
Okay, let me click this contact us. Can you see what is Google Ads, what is SEO, and what is digital marketing? So all my recent things are appearing. Then what about SEO category and Google Ads and digital marketing? Will my blogs appear under categories? I have already categorized them. Will it be saved?
Yes.
Say true.
Yes.
How? I already segregated them under some page like contact us. Then why it appears in SEO and Google Ads?
Because that is a separate categories what we have, and this is the latest update page.
Very good. So now these are the things you can categorize, and this is the latest updates if you want to show. Okay. So, but can I show these blogs in multiple pages like categories? Now here I can create a multiple categories and I show the same blog in the multiple categories. In such a way, can I show these blogs under multiple pages?
No. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Why no?
So there was only one option to choose.
Yes.
Because here I have only one option to choose. Only one page I can choose. Overall the website, you can choose one page as a front page, one place as a post page. Okay?
But right. There is an option of add new page.
Yeah. So instead of creating a pages by going and clicking the page option, you can directly create here. So if you add a page, what happened now? Let us say I create a Google Analytics page. Add it. Okay. So now if you scroll down, it will show. Instead of choosing this about us, sorry, instead of choosing this contact us, Google Analytics is there. Am I right? So again, you can choose it. So I'm just trying to create a page. Got it now? Cleared, Prabhu?
Yeah, I got it.
Yes. So instead of creating a new page over there, directly you can create here. So you can create here and you can choose them. Right. And then publish it. So now it's up to your requirement whether you want to create a static website or dynamic website. Now if I click this about us, I don't have any content here. What if I want to show some content in the about us page? What I have to do? I want to show some content in the about us. What I have to do?
You have to add the content in about us page.
In the about us itself. That's it. So that is what, whatever you write in the about us, it will appear, and when someone searches for direct website, that content will show up here. These are the things you need to know in order to create a website. So decide yourself. Now, Prabhu, your website is a static or dynamic?
It's dynamic.
Mm-hmm. Tell me now. It's a dynamic because I have some home, you know, so you have some posts here. Let me just click this about us and all. The homepage, is it changing? Homepage? No. It's not changing. So yours is a static website. Okay. And about us. Yes, it is a static website. Now go and choose the as a dynamic website if you want to show all your blogs in a front page. Okay. Got it now? It's going, disappearing. Okay. So now, what are these categories? Ad choose and meta, site admin, logout. What are these? So in my website, also it is showing something like recent post, it is appearing. So recent comments. What are those? I don't want to show these kinds of things in my site section. So wherever you go, whatever the website it might be. So the common things are header and footer and then sidebar.
Yeah, sidebar.
Sidebar. So now you know how to edit the header section, you know how to edit the footer. You don't know what is this sidebar. Whatever the thing consisting in the sidebar, that we call it as a widgets. Okay. So you just get into the option called widgets and try to change it here. Now let us see how we can edit this widgets and all. Let's go back. Okay. So find out the option called widgets. Where is widgets? So here, under appearance, there is an option called widgets. Go there. Can you see now? Search. Do I have a search option here? Yes. The next here, recent post, you have a something. Do I have a recent post? Yes. So now this is a sidebar. So if you want to show the things, you can show or else you can delete it. So I don't want to show this search bar. I don't want to show this recent posts. I don't want to show this recent comments as well. So I just deleted all the things. Let's go back and refresh it. Can you see now what happened? Can you see anything? Side section, the side
sidebar
section. Sidebar had been disappeared. So in such a way, whatever you want to show in the sidebar, you can simply show. Now let us say I want to show some calendar in the sidebar. So just choose it, then add a widget here. So if you want to write some title, you can just write it. Calendar, saved. Done. Let's go back and refresh it. Can you see now? Calendar has been added in the side section. And so let me, if you want to have some images, if you want to have some pages, recent post, search, video, if you want to apply some video, you can just apply. Let me just apply some image here. Image. So here you have an option of adding some image. Let me choose this one. So link. What is this link? Link. So let's say when someone click on this image, where you want them to redirect simply. Okay. So if I give a link over here, when someone click on this image, they will redirect to that particular website. Now let us say I want to give a redirection to dizzycodes.in. Copy the complete website URL, then just go back and paste it here. Then save it. And you can edit the image and you can replace the image and whenever you want. Let's go back. Refresh it. Right. Can you see the image, the calendar? So let me click this image now. Where I'm redirecting? It leads to dizzycodes.in. Why it is leading to dizzycodes.in?
because you have given the link of homepage of DigiCourse.
Yes, DigiCourse. What if I don't give? Yes, it will not redirect to anywhere. Am I right? So that is what simply you just need to select. And so now I want to show the same image in the footer sections, like footer widget one. I just choose to image. Tell me where it appears now.
The footer.
The footer. Yes. Go back. Refresh it. Can you see? So by choosing that option only, I came to know that where this image is showing up in the website. So now I found that by using this footer one, so this image is appearing here. So try to use all the options. So just try to use the gallery now. Let me choose gallery for footer. So then next. Let me choose this one. So gallery means combination of images, right? Save it. So where your ad appears? Sorry, image appears. Where your image appears, does it appears in a DigiCourse? Can you see now? Gallery images are appearing here. So in such a way, try to choose whether you want to show up in the footer widget 2 or widget 3. You can simply show up where exactly you want. So if you want to delete, you can just happily delete it whenever you want. Delete. Then delete it.
Can we also add a video?
Video also. So now primary sidebar I choose, like, you know, widget. So can you see here, add a video. Click on this video, and if you have any video on in your desktop, you can simply give that URL. So I have many videos, but it takes some time to upload the video now.
That's okay. I just have a question. That's it. Because today when I try to do some task which has given by you, in that theme, it's showing like video, give a URL link or video or something like that.
So you can give, if it is asking the URL, just copy the YouTube URL and paste over there. So that will become a YouTube URL. So now here, is it asking me the URL? So it is directly asking me the video which has stored in your desktop. If you have, you can just give it. But we don't here. I don't have an option. Now I have one more doubt. Okay, let me just open this DigiCourse. Sorry, where is DigiCourse? Open this. Let me scroll down. What is this session? What is this section normally? Yes? It is a footer section. When someone clicks this examination, where I'll redirect to?
Prospective links.
Prospective links. So how? I have optimized the links. How I can do? Simply go and choose a text option here. So choose text option, and where you want to show? Footer, right?
Yeah.
So just choose the footer option, the next. Let us say now the text option has shown. Now you just need to write latest updates. The next SEO. This is the text. I just tried writing the text option. Let's go back and refresh it. So where it is appearing?
The footer.
On the bottom left side.
Yeah, but is it clickable text now? Is it a clickable text?
No, ma'am.
Then what I have to do? So here, I told you, right, when someone click on that, they are redirecting to the respective URL. How? How I can make that?
We have to give the link.
We have to give the link for what?
Sorry.
So now SEO is there, right?
Yeah.
Now let us say, so copy the URL here. I want to redirect to busycourse.in when someone click on that SEO. Let's go back. So how you can make any text into a clickable text means, select it and use this link option and paste here, apply. So now this SEO has become a clickable text. Then I want to make this Google Ads also a clickable text. Select, click, copy. Select, click, copy. So can I give only busycourse.in URL?
Any URL we can.
Any URL I can give it. Okay, apply it. And save. Done. Let's go back. Refresh it. So now, is it a clickable text now?
Yes.
SEO, Google Ads. Okay, when someone clicks this SEO, where they are redirecting? Redirecting to busycourse.in. Right. So in such a way, you can optimize your footers. You can optimize your sidebar. So whatever you want to show. So let's say I want to show some YouTube channel link in the side section, I can show. So if I want to show some content in the right side, I can show. In such a way, you can show. Let's say if you have an option of choosing the format, like I want to show the sidebar in the left side rather than showing in the right side, you can show. When you have an option of choosing that in the customize option. Okay, so it's up to you. So in such a way, you can design. So now find pages, category. So if you know all these things done, you can create whatever the website you want simply. Got it now? Right. So hope you like this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.